Mossberg's Rugged American Hunter with Jason Cruz.
You know, I really wanted to do this in the field, on the Delta, while we were planting millet. It would have, I think, been cool to do that. The problem was it was loud, the sun was high, it was a million degrees outside, we were a sweaty mess, and I thought it'd be probably better as far as content goes if I could take a few days and just think through this to talk with you about how to plant millet. Now here's the bottom line. Planting millet's not that hard, but when I did a search on it, boy, it's hard to find anything out there of good quality on the process of planting millet. Now you can go to any farmer out there and find out how to do that. But my gut is that most of you watching this video, including me, are not farmers. For us, it's different. It's the process leading up to that, getting to that moment. The older I get, the more demands there are on my time with, you know, raising boys and being a good dad and all the things that requires to being a good husband and work. You know, you have things to do. And so what I want to cover is not just the process of what I went through planting millet, but some things I learned along the way so that when you go to improve your duck hole, you can make that experience work as smoothly as possible. You know, the older I get, the more I see is when you pick a date out there in the future to do something, there's several things you have to do just to get to that date. And that's what this video is going to be about. The number one priority before you go to improve your duck hole is talk to the farmer, if you're leasing. Now, if you're not leasing, well, that's different, of course, but talk to your farmer. Don't just assume that he minds or doesn't mind that you plant millet. He might not want you doing that. Just talk with your farmer. In fact, that brings a whole nother topic of, I would really encourage you to bring your farmer in as a partner. If you're leasing, leases are hard. Good leases are very hard to find on the Delta and really any good duck hunting region of the United States. Quality leases don't come up a lot. So you want to make that farmer sincerely a good friend and treat him right, treat him with an utmost of respect so that you can work together to make your duck hole. I mean, he makes a living off that land. So just never forget that. One piece of encouragement I'd give to you is don't wait until the week before you're planting millet to buy your millet. Thankfully, I got ahead of the game a little bit, but look, a lot of millet is gone from your farm supplies and your co-ops. So, or it has to be ordered because it's late in the year. You need to make sure that wherever you're planning on buying millet from actually has Japanese millet. And how much do they have? Because it's not as easy to find late in the season when you need to plant it as you think it might be. Typically, you're gonna plant it around the 1st of August to the 15th of August on a given year. That's your window of opportunity. But again, most of the time that millet's gone. So think ahead. If for some reason this is your first time to ever plant millet, plan on an all-day event. You might even want to plan on 2 days. I'd block out 2 days just to be safe on a long weekend. I really would. Things can go wrong with farm implements and equipment and weather or whatever you're going to run in. You're going to get in there and disc it up and find out something's not what you thought. So just don't, it's not a quick deal, put it that way. If you can plant millet around a rain, do that. If you know a rain's coming, even if you know it's going to be August 20th for it's supposed to get that way, man, you know, you can, I'd do everything I could to make sure that there's some moisture coming. Boy, you hit a home run if you do that. So let's talk ducks for just a second. Japanese millet is a good food source for that because it's relatively easy. You can fly it over your hole. I chose to plant it because I stand a little bit better chance on the yield of it actually coming up. If you want, not technically a yield, I guess, because you're not harvesting it, but it's gonna grow. I think I can manipulate it a little better. It takes about 60 days, and then you're gonna have it up nice, you know, where your ducks can get to it. With ducks in mind, let me tell you what I did to make and maximize this food plot to the best of its ability. This is a picture of our duck hole from Google Earth. What you have is a swamp kind of in the middle of an agricultural field. It's been there a million years, since God pressed the green light and said, let there be light, and he created the heavens and the earth, this was there. you know, in this depression. Well, it's a natural duck hole. Over time, the water bleeds out of this small swamp, if you will. It's probably 4 foot deep in the dead middle of it. Holds water all year round. What I did for a year was I tracked the wind direction for an entire duck season to get the prevailing winds so that I knew when I come around to this year to plant that millet, that I knew that as a general rule, barring a storm, a weird storm, most always the wind's going to be coming out of the north, northwest, or the due south, southeast. That's the prevailing wind in that area. So I did not plant millet all the way around this duck hole. What I did is I planted it in conjunction with those wind and prevailing winds so that we would have food where the winds were going to work best with that food, and we could hunt it, and I could force them to that point. Here's the process that we used to plant the millet and get it in the ground. I actually used a full-size tractor, not something behind my Honda. I pulled a disker behind it, and we turned that ground over about 2 to 3 times in a 50-yard strip all the way around. The more times you can turn that dirt over and get it nice and loose where it's not huge clumps, that's going to be much to your favor. Millet can't push its way up if it's planted real deep, so you only want it just a little bit below the surface, and if much at all. Some people don't even cover it at all. I just think you lose a lot to doves and other birds that will pick that stuff up, so I think you putting a little bit of cover over it is always a good thing. You're going to need a disc, you're going to need a spreader or a no-till drill, and you're going to need a drag. We used a tractor, drug it, broke up that ground. I went through with a spreader and spread everything as thick as I could, and then I actually went back and spread it multiple ways to layer it in there really well. Millet costs anywhere from $30 to $50 for a bag of it. That bag will cover you can count on, it's a 50-pound bag that I used, and you can look at about 20 pounds per acre when you broadcast spread it, as a general rule. I actually bought a gate, a small gate like you'd use for a chain link fence, because it already had a frame around it. I put a tire on it for weight, and that thing was absolutely awesome. I ran a chain through my hitch on my side-by-side, and that was my drag to cover and smooth that millet over. I loved that system. If there's one thing I will do different next year is I am looking into buying a no-till drill that you just get a even better consistency for that millet planting properly. But if you do spread it, get a spreader that has a ball hitch on it. If you haven't bought a spreader, you're gonna buy one for your ATV, get one with a ball hitch. It takes the abuse so much better. And make sure that your spreader has wide wheels. If you're gonna buy it, buy one that has a wide axle, because when you get them in there narrow, that thing can turn over and lose a whole bag of millet that you have to shovel back up into the spreader. Had a little experience with that in the past. Mossberg is not only committed to creating quality firearms, we're committed to you, to making your field experiences better, which is the purpose of videos like these, to help us all, you know, get better at our craft and enjoy the creation that God made to go hunt, man, and especially chase ducks and knock them out of the sky, man. That's so much fun. But it's the conversations and spending time with your kids or your buddies and your wife, whoever you hunt with, and that's what we're about. Mossberg's always been about family since day one. So I would encourage you, hey, if this video helped you, then post it on your Facebook. Feel free to do that. Hit that like button, share it, tweet it, do whatever you want. In fact, comment on it. If you've had an experience planting millet or any type of food plot for ducks on your impoundment, man, let us know. Gosh, all kinds of people can benefit from that. That is a great conversation to have, and that is the purpose of doing this, is to share knowledge.